Do you also want to know why and how Faraday Future reduced their operational and labor costs? Subscribe to Electric Bike and Car if you love to know more about electric vehicles. Let us start the video. Faraday Future is an American startup company established in 2014 and focused on manufacturing electric vehicles. 8 years have passed since its inception, and Faraday Future is still not able to launch its first production vehicle FF91. There are multiple reasons for this delay, but one of the most important factors is the financial struggles the company was going through these years. Faraday Future is now working to reduce its labor and operating costs. In August 2022, FF announced that it will further raise $600 million worth of investment as funding since they wanted to deliver its flagship all-electric model FF91 later this year. As part of a new financing agreement, the firm will get an initial investment of $52 million in funding. Most F startups that claim to disrupt the automobile industry by offering high-tech solutions are now struggling to secure themselves from decreasing cash flows and rising inflation. Faraday Future is not different from other F startups that went publicly listed through blank check mergers. The EV industry does not progress at a much more rapid rate this year as compared to previous years. The reason for this decline in performance is the strict regulations and rising prices of raw materials. To combat financial difficulties, Faraday Future is now trying to reduce its operational and labor costs. For doing so, multiple strategies have been made and will be adopted in the future. In this article, we have discussed some of the strategies FF is adopting to reduce these costs and go ahead with launching their vehicle soon. Build up manufacturing facility in China. With over 1.4 billion population, China is one of the fastest growing economies in the world. China ranks among the second largest economy per nominal GDP after the US. Over the past four decades, the Chinese government has gradually opened its economy to investors around the world. This has made China one of the top exporters in the world, accompanied by an industrial policy that promotes local manufacturing. In the last two decades, most American companies have built their manufacturing plants in China to take advantage of low-cost labor and established infrastructure. In June 2022, Faraday Future shared the news that it has been planning to build up a manufacturing facility in China by 2025. The company further declared that they are seeking a suitable location to build its future vehicle facility that will also serve as the local headquarters for the Chinese market. There are multiple reasons for entering the Chinese market, despite the company facing financial challenges and SEC investigations. According to Faraday, having a presence in China would enable the business to reduce costs, minimize lead times, and resolve supply chain complexity, while also manufacturing customized vehicles for the regional market. Squeezing current manufacturing. At the time of its foundation, Faraday Future planned to introduce 7 different electric vehicle portfolios but changed the plan after some years. The reason is simple: FF has faced financial crises at different points in time. Now, they have shifted their focus to developing just 2 models, FF91 Futurist Alliance and FF91 Futurist. According to the news report shared by Reuters, the company also squeezed its planned factory size in North Las Vegas, Nevada. As per the change plan, FF will produce 10,000 cars per year instead of 150,000 in 2015. FF wanted to extend its manufacturing facilities, but will do so in the future after getting enough sales of the 2 models. The report also disclosed that Faraday Future may introduce FF81 model, which is lower in price compared to the high-end luxury model FF91. The FF91 car could have a price tag of $300,000, but the company is currently developing this model with 2 variants. Manufacturing and doing R&D work on a single model is a cost-saving option for a company already facing a crisis. Though FF has declared the date of launching their first car later this year, car enthusiasts are still waiting to get the flagship FF91 model all-electric vehicle. Downsizing. Downsizing is a process of reducing a company's workforce or a division to cut costs in case of a financial crisis or recession. According to The Verge, to keep the electric vehicle startup running while it battles with its key investor, Faraday Future is lowering the pay of some of its staff by 20% and laying off some others in 2018. The company's ultimate objective of shipping the first production model of its premium electric car, the FF91, by the end of that year, had suffered a major setback. As a result, till the present year, FF is still delaying the delivery of the FF91 model. The layoff and salary cutting occurs in 2018, and the reason behind this is the back-off by a primary investor, China's Evergrande Health Industry Group Limited. Evergrande Group refuses to pay a $2 billion investment to FF, which was already going under the financial financial crunch. After Evergrande refused to hold its financing contract, Faraday Future is now trying to reduce its operational and labor costs. The company has taken the tough decision of downsizing. Although this has created multiple challenges for the company, it is also unavoidable. Subscribe to Electric Bike and Car if you love to know more about electric vehicles. Sustainable production methods. Achieving a sustainable manufacturing process will not only help to save energy costs, but also protects the environment. Besides delivering an all-electric vehicle which shows the forward-thinking approach of Faraday Future toward clean energy technologies, FF also utilizes a sustainable manufacturing approach in production. Faraday Future is implementing the utilization of sustainable materials and procedures by using cutting-edge production techniques. Designers at FF utilize the conscientious design approach in making a final product. They design every machine and part to be used for years or even decades. They create cars with the full life cycle in mind, so the majority of their parts may be recycled or repurposed when a car reaches the end of its useful life. Therefore, sustainable production techniques not only save operational costs, but also make our planet a cleaner and greener place to live. Provide training. All workers at the factory should be well trained in their respective domains. Initial and ongoing training programs should be held at FF, which empower the workforce to implement best practices in production. It will reduce errors and enhance productivity. Increase safety. FF should invest in increasing their employees' safety within their facility. Employees are the most asset for any company. Therefore, safety protocols not only reduce the chances of accidents but also reduce labor compensation costs. Check out the article link in the description to learn more in depth. Standardization. Standardization of processes and procedures will increase production as well as in achieving economies of scale. Adopting standardization in manufacturing will decrease errors, increase productivity, and enhance workers' efficiency. Faraday Future is already implementing a VPA approach to manufacture every part of the car that considerably reduces operational costs. Technology implementation. Although FF has the edge in implementing high-tech engineering solutions for all phases of manufacturing, whether it is an AI-based user interaction program, the use of FF Echelon Inverter, zero-gravity seat design, or multiple other tech aspects already discussed, Faraday Future is bridging the gap between traditional traveling with future ways of mobility. Conclusion. By reducing labor and operating costs will add up and become a significant part of Faraday Future's budget. While there are multiple ways to minimize these costs and increase the overall productivity of a company, as we have discussed how FF is implementing various approaches to minimize these costs, we have also recommended some of the strategies that can be adopted by FF to enhance overall efficiency. We hope that the challenges faced by FF will be proactively tackled by their management and launch the flagship vehicle soon. Subscribe to Electric Bike and Car if you love to know more about electric vehicles, and I will see you in the next one.